Today I will present a study that is about the effect of activity on the association of two organelles, which are crucial for skeletal muscle function, calcium release units and mitochondria. Calcium release units are specialized intracellular junctions deputed to excitation contraction coupling, the mechanism that allow transduction of the electrical signal coming from the neuromuscular junction into release of calcium from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Calcium release during EC coupling activates muscle contraction, and fibers will then relax when calcium is pumped back into the SR by the Circa pumps. It has been known for a long time that a small amount of the calcium released during EC coupling also enters mitochondria, the intracellular organelles deputed to produce ATP during cellular respiration. Functionally, entry of calcium to the mitochondrial matrix is metabolically important to stimulate the respiratory chain and to increase cellular ATP production during muscle contraction. However, it has been proposed that mitochondria to uptake calcium efficiently must be placed in close proximity to sites of calcium release, and our lab has become interested in this scientific issue since 2009 when Simona Boncompagni and colleagues published a paper describing the spatial disposition of these two intracellular organelles. Mitochondria, impassed with skeletal muscle fibers, are placed at the high band of sarcomere, next to the Z-line and in close proximity to calcium release units, which in skeletal muscle are also called triad because they are formed by one transverse tubule coupled to two terminal cisternae of the SR. And as you heard from Simona and Feliciano, we believe that the spatial disposition is likely important for SR mitochondria calcium signaling and likely for proper metabolic efficiency of muscle fibers, as we found different conditions in which this precise disposition is lost, like denervation, aging, and several myopathies. And now we will talk about aging. In a recent paper, we have shown that in fibers from aged mice, part of mitochondria and calcium release units lose their precise disposition. In this double immunolabeling, we marked in red ryanodine receptors, while the green staining marks position of mitochondria. And as you can see here, the perfect double cross-striation of adult fibers is partially compromised in fibers from aged mice, with areas in which mitochondria clusters in longitudinal rows. And these electron microscopy images show triads within an improper oblique or longitudinal orientation, and mitochondria extending longitudinally between myofibrils. These data were published in this 2015 paper, in which to assess whether aging also caused changes in the association of the mitochondria to calcium release units, we quantified the number of tethers, the small electron dense strands that you heard from Simona, that link the outer mitochondrial membrane to a terminal cisterna of the SR. And the results of these experiments indicated that the number of tethers was significantly reduced in fibers from aged mice, while average minimum distance between adjacent mitochondria and the SR membranes was significantly increased in fibers from aged mice compared to that of adult mice. And in the same paper, we also hypothesized that age-related elevation on oxidative stress could activate a dangerous feed-forward mechanism in which excessive calcium leak and the production of reactive oxygen species could damage membranes and lipids and determine the uncoupling of mitochondria from calcium release units. So, in the last 5 years in our lab, we have been working on the following scientific hypothesis. The correct association between calcium release units and mitochondria, which is challenged by aging and inactivity, can be maintained and improved by muscle activity and exercise. So, we worked on three different groups of samples in collaboration with Helmut Kerr in Vienna, Sandra Zampieri, and Ugo Carraro in Padova. We analyzed human biopsies from young adults, sedentary seniors, and aged match sportsmen who had exercised regularly at least in the second part of their life. They were mastery bikers, skiers, and are training in the gym. We then studied also ideal muscle for mice, either aged and aged matched mice, which had access to training wheel for 1 year, starting at 1 up to 2 years of age. Finally, we also evaluated the effect of denervation in rats, a condition of acute inactivity that in rats can be reverted. In collaboration with the research group in Urbino, we studied ideal muscle from rats denervated for 15 days by nerve crush, and denervated plus reinnervated for 15 plus 30 days, a period of time which allow regeneration of the crushed nerve. Using electron microscopy, we analyzed in human biopsies frequency expressed as number per area of section, morphology, and orientation of calcium release units in mitochondria. And today I will show the most striking results. With age, number, volume, and association of mitochondria to calcium release units were significantly reduced, where these age-related changes were almost completely prevented in sportsmen. Number and volume and association of mitochondria to calcium release units were very similar to that observed in young controls. These data were published in 2015, and this electron microscopy image summarizes changes we have observed in aging muscles. Mitochondria and calcium release units lose their correct morphology and orientation. On the other hand, in panel C and D, there are images from a sportsman of the same age. In this case, mitochondria, which are indicated by the white arrows, are correctly positioned on both sides of a Z-line. And calcium release units, indicated by the small black arrows, have the classical element, three-element structure, hence the Lemmy triad, and are often correctly associated to mitochondria, as in the enlargement in panel D. To confirm human biopsy data, we started the rigorous and controlled studies in animal models to reinforce evidence that muscle activity improves or maintains the correct association between calcium release units and mitochondria. This slide summarizes the structural studies carried out in aged and age trained mice. The co-immunostaining for RYR1 and TOM20, marking respectively the position of triads and mitochondria, showed that the precise double cross striation of adult fibers, partially compromised in fibers from aged mice, was completely restored after long-term training. The electron microscopy analysis confirmed how exercise improved the mitochondrial positioning and exerted also a positive effect on morphology and disposition of triads. And the quantitative analysis shown in these bar graphs confirmed that exercise counteracted effectively the changes induced by the inactive aging. Moreover, we evaluated also if voluntary exercise was able to improve the muscle function of aged mice. So we measured in vivo grip strength and ex vivo contractile force in aged and age-trained mice. And the results obtained confirmed how exercise was able to improve force, both in vivo during grip strength and ex vivo in isolated intact ideal muscle studied in a setup in which dissected muscle are studied on a force transducer. So our studies on human biopsies and mice gave enough evidence that muscle activity improves or maintains the correct association between calcium release units and mitochondria. But too many issues remain to be fully elucidated. Reduced muscle activity would have the same effect also in adult muscle. And is the uncoupling between calcium release units and mitochondria a reversible process? To test this hypothesis, we analyzed a model of transient denervation in rats. We studied ideal muscle in rats, either by confocal and electron microscopy. We studied ideal muscle after 15 days by denervation by nerve crush, a stage in which muscle are still denervated, and after 45 days, a period of time sufficient to allow reinnervation of muscle fibers for regeneration of the crushed nerve. And as you can see here, in don't control ideal muscle from rats, both mitochondria and calcium release units form the classical striation identical to that observed in mice, and this staining reflected the ordered disposition of these organelles visible in electron microscopy. In the enervated samples, though, this ordered disposition was compromised, as you can see here, by immunofluorescent and electron microscopy pictures. However, reinnervation completely restored the normal appearance of skeletal muscle fibers, and these qualitative observations were confirmed by the data presented in these bar graphs. And importantly, the decreased association between calcium release units and mitochondria caused by denervation was completely rescued when enough time was given to the nerve to reinnervate muscle fibers. In this final cartoon, we model changes induced by aging to the architecture of the sarcotubular system and to mitochondria. The calcium release units in yellow and white and mitochondria decrease in frequency and lose their correct morphology and position. And we believe that the decreased association contributes to the decreased efficiency of aged muscle to produce energy and would result in reduced endurance and force. But our study suggested that these changes can be almost completely prevented by exercise during aging, and that this process is reversible at least after a short disuse. To conclude, our findings suggest that the changes we have described are affecting the association of structure involving aerobic ATP production and calcium handling are caused by inactivity more than age per se. I would like also to thank all the people that contributed to produce the data presented in this slide at our institution, at the Universities of Padova and Urbino, and all of you for being today. Thank you.
Thank you, Laura. Thank you for this presentation. During this last two presentations, I thought about something. It looks like mitochondria are kind of selfish. I mean, they are dog, they are stay next to calcium release units until these easy coupling sites works properly. And then when it starts to be some problems like denervation or aging and the easy coupling sites doesn't work so efficiently, they recover their own dynamicity. It's like they go back because they don't want to stay anymore there because it's not convenient. So it looks like to me that mitochondria really are kind of selfish. Don't you think, Feliciano? Feliciano, are you there?
Oh, I'm not sure. I don't know. I mean, I never thought about
it. Yeah, they stay there until it's convenient. But when there is some problem, instead of help the problem,
they go back. The longitudinal disposition is the disposition they have before the muscle is adult.
Yes, during maturation, and then they go back also with aging and denervation. It's like they recover their own dynamicity, because as you said, in other cells, mitochondria are moving, are kind of more mobile, right?
Maybe we should ask if there are questions from other people, though.
Yes, sorry, yes.
May I ask a question to Laura or to Feliciano about this? I mean, what can be the...
Laura.
You have some clue about the mechanism of this motility of the mitochondria. Can be the dictator some cytoskeleton structure which can have some mobility based, I don't know, about on kinesin or some non-muscle myosin which can pull the mitochondria up and down close to the calcium release unit and away, or the mitochondria themselves can move. You have some clue about the mechanism?
Well, we don't know exactly which are the mechanisms that cause the uncoupling of mitochondria from calcium release units. And to tell you the truth, we don't know whether this uncoupling is the cause of the reduced number of tethers, the links that makes the mitochondria stay with the calcium release units, or if it is the contrary. So I think we need to investigate further.
We only know that oxidative stress in all both conditions is high. So, but we don't know if...
No,
we should start looking at the internal cytoskeleton, definitely.
Yes, the cytoskeleton, but I think we
can... see if there are some motors that can move things around.
Yes. Yeah.
We need help. Maybe Gaia knows some about this, more about the mechanism of fission, fusion, and movement. I don't know.
Movement, in this case.
I agree. My idea is that there is something that, and I don't know what is the mechanism. The problem is that the mitochondria and the calcium release units are not together. But yes, the point is why and which is the mechanism. And I am waiting for you.
No, I mean, this concept of position and coupling, it is really new. And it is new, the fact that inactivity uncouples and activity couples. I hope that some people is gonna get interested and help us to get to find the molecular models for this. Yeah.
Yes, but we were interested too, of course, because then we move on the inside of the mitochondria, but we have the problem before, so outside the mitochondria. So, okay, the mitochondria is dysfunctional, but because there is something in the cytosol that signal to the mitochondria, and the mitochondria are dysfunctional. So,
may I make not a comment, but a proposal. Specialization and the other on AC coupling. My interest to understand why the nuclei move out from sarcolemma to the intermyofibrillar space by any stupid disturbances to the muscle fiber. Could be this a topic for next year, or is too early?
Movement. I think it's definitely important. I mean, inactivity creates disorganization of mitochondria and also nuclei.
If you go to PubMed or any database and type central nuclei, the only explanation is block of differentiation for the skeletal muscle. They explain these strange events, which is even more evident than the what happens between mitochondria as a myotubes. Myotubes are added the myofibers. Initially, all the nuclei are in the center of the small fibers, then they move out. And therefore, if I see a nuclei that is in the is a problem in differentiation, but this is not true, because even in adult, in few hours, the nuclei may move from sarcolemma inside. And these are major movement, and the same is true for mitochondria. In a few days, you activate the muscle, they recover the position. The evidence on the importance of activity is, I think, no one can have a doubt. The question is who drive the bikes?
I think some people that study the intracellular cytoskeleton say that.
Yes, we have to find. I am sure that there are people experts.
Fiber works as sensors of movement.
Yes.
Maybe connected to the costomeres. So there are some movement. Some people say is that in the fiber there are some sensors of movement.
It's the timer so providing other people to talk, and creating no space for our young people, because this is the risk. I am in doubt that we provide our space, our minimal space in asking for this. But this is one of the mystery, one of the many mystery of the mass biology, mass physiopathology.